9:15. Over the past few years, the Pussycat Dolls have become one of the biggest girl bands around, with worldwide hit singles such as Don't Ya and Stick With You.
Now, though, the lead singer, Nicole Scherzinger, is hoping for solo success. She's just released a single called Poison, already doing very well in the charts. We'll talk to her in a moment. First, here is a dose of it.
Got venom dripping from my lips. Know who you're about to kiss. Think that you can handle it. Poison. Just step into the danger zone. Sugar, if you want to roll. And a pen, just take control. Stakes are on. So sick, kill it quick, gonna stick to a slick. I don't think that I can stop. Pick it up, let it drop in my cup, sip it up. Oh no, I'll never stop. That bad girl.
There's talent for you, see? She can flip the opposition over and change clothes, just like that.
Here you go.
Morning. And drive morning. The car without touching the steering wheel, which is a particular skill.
Right.
Nice
with
to see
my
you,
toe.
Nicole.
Nice to see you. Good morning.
Well, the single's done really well, hasn't it?
I'm so excited. It's my third day on top of the download charts. Number one in UK, iTunes. So I'm so grateful to everyone out there. Thank you.
Were you a bit nervous about going solo after the success of the Pussycat Dolls?
I mean, obviously, you've got to be courageous and brave. But some of the girls in the group left and wanted to pursue their solo careers because in the end, we're all individuals. And I'm really happy for them. So it gave me the opportunity to continue music, which is what I love. And I'm more sad because I miss them on stage and I miss their energy, but I'm so excited. Like, I love the single, I love the album that I'm working on, and this is a great time for me.
Have you been out on stage alone so far?
Yeah.
You've been performing live.
Do you want me to hit you?
Go on, yes, do. Oh, harder.
Somebody has.
No, I my first performance.
Of course you did X Factor on Saturday. Thank you,
my first performance was X Factor.
Exactly.
Yes.
So, you know, that's not
judge,
anything to be afraid of.
There you, there you are. Ah, yes, there you are.
And that must have been quite a moment for you, actually, because you were a judge. How many weeks were you a judge for?
I was for a couple of weeks,
a couple of weeks. And then there you are performing in front of the X Factor crowd.
That's the poison smoke, that green smoke that just came up. Yes, so that was my very first performance of this this song and this my first single. So,
but much more pressure on you individually as a result, because if there's a number of you together on stage, then so does the folks.
I don't
show,
see it that way. Okay. I don't see it as pressure. I see it. I obviously, like I said, I miss the presence and the energy of the girls. Mm. But I still carry it with me on stage. I don't see it as precious. This is what I love to do. And I put everything into that X Factor performance. So hopefully, so far it's been well received. And just means a lot that the single's doing well. And I can't wait to perform it again. I get to perform it this Saturday at the O2 Arena at the Capital Radio show for Jingle Bell Balls. And it's a good time right now. I feel like unleashed. And just the music is rocking out. It's like up-tempo. It makes you want to get up and dance.
Yeah. You're quite a good judge of talent, I have to say, while I was watching you as the judge on X Factor, because I think most of the acts you chose are still in it, aren't they?
See
You
got a little pat, and she got a high five.
Okay.
No, I'm not going to say anything, but I was there, I believe, for Rebecca's first audition.
Yeah.
And I always told Simon, that's my songbird right there. And then I did kind of help him out with the whole One Direction thing, putting the group together.
Actually, we were talking about pressure earlier. You know pressure because you were on Dancing with the Stars, which we know is strictly on dancing, and you actually went on and won it, didn't you?
Yeah, with Derek Huff. Yeah, he's the great partner, so I have to give it over to him.
I mean, it's a big show here in Britain. I suppose it's massive in America, isn't it? Because you've got
One of the Pussycat Dolls' first shows over here was to be able to do Strictly Come Dancing when I did a song called Sway. So it is pretty massive. It was the number one show in America. Mm. And I never thought I'd be ballroom dancing, and there I was.
What was your favorite dance doing that?
I had a couple favorites. I liked the Argentine tango and the 50s Paso Doble.
Oh, yes.
But you were in another reality show, because what was he called? Eden's Crush, was it? Yeah. The girl band that you were in the reality show. So you know what it's like to be in front of judges.
Completely. That's how I got my start. I came from a really small, humble background, and I didn't know how I was going to get to that place, Hollywood, California. So I ended up driving up to a close city and going out for this audition for the show called Pop Stars, which I believe they have different ones around the world. And auditioned and was asked to be a part of this group, Eden's Crush. So that's how I got my start. It brought me to Los Angeles.
So many people want to follow that kind of career path, though, and sort of see stardom and celebrity. I want to get there. And you've, from, you know, grassroots, you've done it. I mean, there's no sort of simple formula, presumably. But what would you say to somebody who says, I want to be a star?
Just
like
don't
you?
Give up. Any window of opportunity, just go for it. You know, I loved to sing, so we didn't have means of like a voice teacher or anything growing up. So I told my mom, I want to go to the youth performing arts school. So fortunately, we had one, and I got a great foundation there. I got involved with theater, singing. Sing with your favorite CDs and radio. Mm. Like, just don't give up and keep trying it. Keep doing it.
Keep your eyes on the prize.
Yeah. Yeah.
You've had loads of hits with the Pussycat Dolls, and I wonder whether now you're all looking at your own solo stuff, whether you'll be definitely coming back together and still touring and putting out albums.
I'm not sure. I mean, there's always the possibility that we want to hold because it was such an amazing time for us. But like I said, I know some of the girls are doing their own stuff as well. I'm really happy for them. And I couldn't be happier right now. I feel like this is a good time for this to be happening. Mm.
You said you didn't know the way to Hollywood earlier, but you've found the way now because you've just been in the latest Men in Black film, is that right?
Right. Okay, you get a high five there.
Oh, thank you.
Me and you.
Right at the end. High five. Excellent.
Yeah, I'm shooting Men in Black now, actually. I was there right before I did the X Factor performance in New York City, and I get to go back this December. I'm working with an amazing director, Barry Sonnenfeld.
And you play?
My character's name is Lily. Okay. Yes, she's kind of a villain.
Oh,
two
kind of a
very, very brief answers before you go. Are you going to be doing X Factor with Cheryl Cole in the United States?
I'm not sure. I have to wait and to see if Simon would ask me.
Okay. He hasn't asked you yet.
He hasn't asked me yet.
Okay. And the other one is Rebecca going to win?
I don't know if she's going to win. That's not up to me. It's not up to me. I think everyone has their own, they could all win, rightfully so. They have their own special talent. But I know that if she wins or not, I'm still going to be listening to her voice.
Okay.
She is your songbird.
She's my songbird. Mm. And I'm going to share with you all.
Thank you very much. Good. Can we just do one more? High five again.
Right here.
Okay, can I give you the love pat?
Oh. Yay! Love pat.
Never gonna
all
wash
around.
This hand again.
Love pat.
That's what
it's
she called it.
The poison pat.
Thank you, Nicole. Thank you, Barry.
And the single Poison is out now, and it's already doing very well.
Time for a last look at the weather. Calm down. Time for a last look at the weather. Here's Louise. What have you
shame
done?
Me here. Oh,